Hello everyone. I'm in the middle of clearing out the area again, and I was going to get it all done before I initiated the recording, but listen, just listen. I couldn't help it. The music is just so beautiful. And the death. It's amazing, isn't it? Brutality. It's magical. Okay, obviously I turned off the ENB. For the ease, you know. The ease of work or something like that. I don't know. Come up with some sort of excuse. Here we go. Now, how much damage did we take? Quite a bit. Yeah, I just got a little bit romantic, you know. Okay. Alright, welcome back to Frost. So I'm in the middle of clearing out the area again. I'll get us to the point where we're ready to go, and I'll see you in a second. Alrighty, we are ready to go. So we took a little bit of damage from all those ghouls, but we somehow, at some point, discovered a beast of a gun. I found the M1 Garand again. But check this out. Yeah, we've got a little save here. We're not overburdened as we go. I've deposited all of our gear into the bag. Have a look at this. Converted heavy carbine, 5mm. An absolute beast of a gun. We've only got 7 rounds for it, but it does 63 damage. But it's our first proper ranged weapon, like long range weapon. So we might have to have a little bit of a play. And we've got a little bit of a healing items in effect. We've got to have a look at this. Wow. Is it night vision as well? Oh, I think it is. Night vision scope, long night vision scope. Might be very useful to us right now. Considering we need to... Where are we now? We're over here, aren't we? Alright, cool. So, we can get ourselves... our hands on a few 5mm rounds. We can do a little bit of long distance sniping. And maybe take out... This kind of blocks the view a bit, doesn't it? Take out a few enemies. Could see so much more when I did this, you know. Inside that building then. Just thought I'd do it for a bit of ease. Ease of use, or you know what I'm trying to say, make the job a little bit easier, get it done a bit quicker. I don't know, I don't remember when I picked this gun up. Anyway, back on with the job. Getting us home safely. Let's have a little look in here first. Oh my god, I can't see a thing. Let's check it out, eh? So this could well be the last episode of Frost for the week. And it'll come back at some point. I don't know when. But it'll come back. If you've enjoyed the series and you want to see more, you know, feel free to let me know in the comments. But, as I mentioned in the last episode, I'll be releasing a video soon, sort of asking what people want to see out of a few different games. So, you know, you can look out for that one. I'm still trying to figure out exactly how to gauge what to put on the channel and how to run it, how often to play certain games. So I think I might ask for a little bit of feedback on that as well. You know, do you like the whole one game a week format? Would you rather see a bit more diversity in a week, you know? I'm trying to figure it out myself, but I would appreciate a little bit of input if anybody wants to comment and let me know. But yeah, I'll come up with a proper way to, a proper format for that question. And I'll put it in a video. Don't really need to get into it here, do I? I suppose. Maybe let's just focus on what we're doing. We're frosting our way through the Commonwealth. Cool, I thought that was a mine then. Bloody mini nuke. Is this the way we came in or what? Ooh, okay. Oh, there was a whole heap of books. That Abraxo cleaner's good. It gives us antiseptic. I feel like I'm about to run into a mine. Nice. I suppose we could turn the 7.62 into a sniper rifle since we've got a lot of rounds for it. Okay. I know there's another kind of area in here. We didn't discover this place, did we? Maybe you have to come at it from a certain angle, do you? I know there is a few different entrances to that building. Oh well. Yeah, the radiation levels are getting up there a little bit again. Look at the steadiness of this scope. That's crazy. Crazy good. What do we got here too? Another parking garage. I guess this is probably going to be pretty full of ghouls, is it? Yep. Don't really want to be pushing my luck right now. I might just head home, I think. Oh yeah, the hospital. It's kind of on the way home, isn't it? Shit. I think I've screwed up here. Oh, nice. That was lucky. Whew. Okay, where's home? that way. Oh, it's miles away. Okay, I guess we're going round. Oh dear God. Why do I do this to myself? Okay, I think we might be alright. This place is not friendly at all. Come on, we can do this. Shit. How about you are so dead? Tell you what, I like the sound of this gun. Just sounded so shit. Get him. Oh my God, what is going on right now? Where did all these people come from? Oh, nice. Got a level up as well. Okay, that was the head. Might keep that. Bit of a trophy, you know? What's going on right now? Can't see a damn thing. I don't know why I want to keep this, but I do. Don't ask. No mines anywhere? Okay, I'm just going to leave it. Right, it wasn't meant to be. Okay, alright. That was very odd. Okay, we've made it. Okay, let me get all that stuff sorted. Right, we are totally set. Although, we only have 3 rounds for this. But, given the nature of the gun, I think it's, you know, those 3 rounds are essentially 3 kills. So I'm going to keep hold of it for now. Tell you what, it's a good looking gun, isn't it? Just a shame that the, kind of scope covers half the screen, but I suppose I can put it away. Now, we picked up some Carmex, which is going to take our sanity back up to 75, so we're going to have that. Where is it here? It's going to make us thirsty, I think. But we'll cook something. What have I got? I should have a ton of boiled water in here already. Or a little bit. Okay. Kind of boosts our rads back up. We do really kind of need to discover a chem bench at some point soon so we can make more rad away. I didn't make any more, did I? No. Bugger. I've got all the ingredients to make it, but we need to discover a chem bench or go back to the underground where we know where there is one. We've got a little bit of beer. Let's get that into us. It takes away some rads. What does it work out? Was it 2 minutes? So I've already drank it, haven't I? So we're okay, we're alright, we've got lethargy. We've got a level up as well. What should we take? Might have to have a little look in here as well. There was a few here that I was weighing up last time. 50% less likely to get addicted to chems could be useful. We don't use them that much, but I could. You know, if I knew there was less threat. That'd be a good one. Trader. We've got to ignore Wanderer. Intimidation. Medic. Gun Knot is another one we want. Sneak as well. Sneak might be decent for avoiding ferals. We take sneak. At this point, I think there's not really much we can do except explore the wasteland, gather loot, prepare ourselves for the settlement construction. But we do need armorer, blacksmith for that. Maybe we take armor. We don't have an armorer, an armor workbench nearby that I know of. Okay, give me a second. Okay, I took toughness. And my logic being that we need to be able to survive out here. And, you know, we've got to... we've kind of just got to keep doing what we've been doing, looting. You know, getting into a little bit of combat here and there, surviving, building up our XP. So that's my kind of thinking behind it. You know, if we've got... I really need to make some more right away. If we've got a greater damage resistance, you know, we're going to last longer. So for right away, I needed 2 purified water, 4 glowing fungus, some plastic, was it? Shit. Tell you what, I suppose I could take all my junk. Just take it with us in the bag. That's a lot of junk. So we're going to have to go and do a trip now. Back to a chem station. The only one I really know of is underground. So, you know, we don't really have a choice. Gonna have to do something about this. These rads that are building up. See how we go. We've got our buzzsaw. And we've got our rifle with 3 rounds in it. Which is really just a last resort. Yeah, the only one I know of that I can remember is back down here. There's likely... Oh, what's this one? I don't know what that place is. Maybe we check that out on the way. We've only got to get to there, so it's down the road, you know? There's probably other chem benches around that I just can't remember. Like, there's probably likely one in there. Let's go and have a look at this place. I can't remember what that is. Sort of feeling a little bit more familiar with the area now. And kind of traverse around a little bit quicker, but I know there's still a ton of ghouls around. and mines in one direction. You know, there were two mines inside that building we just looted, the one with all the ghouls in it, where we started the episode today. There were two mines sitting there, right next to each other the whole time that we missed in the darkness. And I only spotted them because I turned off the EMB. There's so much around that you don't see because of how dark it is. I love that sound. So visceral, you know, so meaty. Like, it makes you think there's a proper monster around. You know, not just a ghoul or something, it makes you think there's some sort of beast nearby. That sounded like a nice gun. I think I want it. But where was the gunfire coming from? That's what I want to know. Maybe over this way. Yeah, the scope on this is insanely still, look. Like, I'm just holding my finger down, not moving my hand. You okay there, monkey? You want a chocolate? Yeah, get one. What have we got here? Crash vertebrate, is that? Thank you. Are you having a koala? Is it James, you want one? Okay, we're here. Let's have a look at this place. What is this? It's not a vertebrate, is it? It's a bloody boat. Practically a ship.
Where'd that little bitch go? Fucking hide from me? You're dead.
Isn't the sound of that, man? It's lovely, isn't it? This isn't the one who had the... Oh, it is too. Never mind. She didn't have many cells for it, did she? We've only got one shot left in this. Isn't the sound of it though? Let's have a little look in here then. BADCFL. What's going on with that turret? Going on in there, but I know we're gonna have to kill everyone to find out.
could kill him.
You can try.
I'll find you.
Come on now, you've been watching the episodes long enough. You've got to expect one or two self-imposed explosive deaths, you know. It's just the way this works now. Crap. I wasn't expecting him to come through that other door. That was a problem there. Like, because of the darkness, you just can't see, you know. Can't see what's going on around the place. We didn't even travel very far then. Watch, I'll just make a beeline straight for it this time. We'll be there in no time. Look, it's already showing up on the compass. It just feels so long, doesn't it? Because you go so slow. What's going on here? What are you playing at? Sitting in the road like that? Silly. Silly person. They were probably going to kill me first. That's what survivors do, isn't it? KOS. No questions asked. We've already played that game. I've tried to be nice. Look, we're already here. What have we got here? Hiya. You son of a bitch. Oh wow. Is that dead? It's still not dead. I can't believe how tough that thing was. Yeah, I think I'm about to die anyway. Let's have a look. 26 HP. Didn't quite kill us, did it? Where's the...
Are you fucking kidding me?
Here we go. Okay, let's see what we can do about healing. Let's do it. Let's get it into us. I'm not drinking that. I didn't bring any more water though. He's out of it. He's out of it, that guy, completely. Did I kill everyone?
Who's there?
That'd be a no.
You hear that?
Did I put a mine through here or what? Yeah, I did. Forgot to save.
Nothing there now.
I've got no more ammo for this. Okay, that's fine.
Jumping in shadows. Yeah, you're probably right. You gotta cut down on the
gym. Might not go that way right now. Someone's bound to walk through that door.
Who's out there?
Forgot about the turret. What are we going to do about that? We've got no more ranged weapons. Oh wait, I just picked up a little handgun, didn't I? This one.
What do you think?
Oh wow, look at that.
Yeah. Now don't start talking crazy.
Reminds me of Beavis and Butthead that. Is that a turret? Oh, it is too. A little bit excessive, don't you think? A little bit excessive. Be a fair decent. What's that? Who's he shooting at now? Oh wow. They're fighting each other.
Who's out there?
Interesting.
Hey. Who's there? Scared, huh?
Playing games with me, huh?
Time to reel them in. Ain't personal, just you or me.
Turret's taking everyone out. Did my mind went off already, didn't it? We're gonna have to do something about that turret. I go this way.
Show your face! Come on! I dare you! Come on out! I'll make it nice and quick. You can trust me.
Suppose I should check that body and see if it has any ammo.
Still kicking? Jesus!
Try again.
Nothing there now. What do you think? Jump in the shadows. Yeah, you're probably right.
I don't know if we're gonna get that lucky again with that this turret here.
You gotta be joking.
How many people we got here? Shit. Man, those power hits get me every single time. I just don't know what to do about him. I mean, you just got to dodge him, don't you? You can't block. What do you think?
Jump into shadows. Yeah.
All right. Forget the loot. Is there another mine down here already? There is too. Is that one of mine? Must be.
You were so boom. Dead.
Shit, it went off behind the door. That wasn't the right load. That was the incorrect load. Let us reload the load. Don't know why it does that sometimes. Okay, let's try again. It's like a puzzle, isn't it?
Nothing there now.
It's doable. I know it's doable. I can feel it in my bones. It's doable. Just gotta find the right combination of actions.
Yeah, you're probably right. You gotta cut down on the Jedi, guys.
Don't stop talking crazy!
We're getting there. It's a process.
Jump in.
So I've got one down here. Yeah, I've got one down here.
Gotta cut down on the jet, I guess.
Man, I'm starting to not like this buzzsaw as much.
Nothing there now.
Have I got anything else? No.
Now, what do you think? I don't know. Yeah, you're probably right. You gotta cut down on the Jedi yet.
Oh, where'd that little bitch go?
What did I just pick up then? Tell you what, I'll just drop all. Drop that. No. Wrong key. Just drop all this stuff we're not using for now. Let's get that one there. Although I don't like the fact that it's scoped. Oh shit. Okay, well that was nice. Oh dear. Whoa, what was that? What was that that just hit me? Okay, there's a few more in here than I'd kind of anticipated, so we've got to kill a couple at least to get out of here.
Don't start talking crazy.
Hey!
Hey, wait, what?
Huh?
Okay, cut the shit. Who is that?
How about one of those? I don't think I've used these before. I feel like I'm missing a mine, but Well, we've killed a couple, so we can technically get out of here now. Who's that shooting at? What the? What are we going to do about that turret?
Hey. I think someone's out there.
Oh shit, that's what it was. Bastard. That's what took me out, wasn't it? Alright, we might have overstayed our welcome here.
I don't know. Jump in a jet.
We just don't quite have enough ammo.
Yeah, you're probably right. Gotta cut down on the jet, I guess.
Give me my mines back. We gotta kill Chu. We killed two. And what's here that's expensive? Anything? Cool, there's nothing here. Worthless.
What? Nothing.
Shit. She's on her way down, isn't she? Our girl. She's on her way down. Oh well, we've got a little bit of stuff. She's gonna go insane at the end of the day. I'm trying to kind of postpone it a little bit so it's a slow descent, you know, it's not a rapid, immediate descent into insanity. You know, she's managed to last this long, you know, surviving, as in this long, her backstory before we were introduced to Evie. She's managed to last this long in the Wasteland without going completely insane in the Commonwealth. We'll get that dog with a mine. I don't know what to do about that thing up there. But, you know, she was captured. She was captured and held prisoner. Which was the first major push over the edge. And, you know, we can say that the whole time that we've known her, she's been falling over the edge, and the longer we get to know her, you know, you can say she's holding on essentially to her sanity. She's doing her best, but slowly but surely, she's on the way down to a very, very deep, dark mental environment. And as we're beginning to see here, she's thinking less and less about what she's doing. And acting more and more impulsively, and just carelessly in the sense of you know, when people do things with a careless attitude, often that's interpreted as they're not putting forth effort or.
Okay, cut the shit. Who is that?
How else should I word that?
You guys got me stirred up over nothing.
You know, she's driven. She's got a motive here. She knows what she's doing, but she doesn't care about the fact that she's
you are so dead.
Slaughtering people. It's necessary at the end of the day. Ain't careless in that sense. She doesn't care anymore. But she's intentional about what she's doing here. So it's not careless in that sense. Jesus, man. Navich. Shit, I'm on fire. I don't know if that's gonna help. Alright, I've squeezed this lemon long enough. Is that how you say that? I've squeezed these oranges long enough? I don't know. I've used this environment too long, so let's get out of here. I've got to kill two. We kill two, we go. You know, I've had enough chances here. Unbelievable.
Gotta cut down on the Jedi, I guess.
We're so dead!
Yeah, I'll take whatever I can get at this point. Wow, look at my health. Well, we took two out. Essentially, that's our, you know, that's our way of saying we got in, we cleared it a little bit. So there's a fine balance between, you know, as much as you might want to push it, kill a couple more, kill one more, try and get a little bit more loot. You end up dying, start all over again. It's a roll of the dice. It's like a gamble. Literally everything you do with regards to playing like this, it's like you're always weighing up, is it worth the gamble of trying to push it to that next level? Hey Liv, is that heater turned off, darling? Can you just check and make sure it's turned off, please? It is, alright. Alright, so, we got our save. Let's push on, back to Valenti Station. So we're only just going down here. For, what is that place anyway? I still don't even know what that place is. I guess we're going to have to go back there at some point. You know, as we go past it, we can go in and clear one or two more enemies. Have a little bit more gear on us. Isn't this, Bunker Hill? Yeah, there's bound to be a few mines around here. And enemies. But we've got to check it out, don't we? Who's here? Shit. Yeah, I had a feeling they'd be well armed. So we found our settlement, guys. We know where we're gonna be focused on clearing. Most likely the next time we play Frost, we're gonna take Bunker Hill and we're gonna turn it into our central hideout, central hideout for our gang. It's perfect. We needed a place central to the map-ish. You know, it's central-ish. Central enough. And we just need one place to start off with. We've got this until we're strong enough. We've got enough gear to take on this. I might even try and recruit. No, I think I'll clear Bunker Hill by myself. We've got to set precedence, you know, Evie. She's got to set the precedence that she's in charge and she knows what she's doing. So she clears the place by herself and then opens up the door to survivors that she meets. Possibly even traders, travelers. You know, you got the recruitment beacon, so we can put that on, pull one or two people in, test them out with a little bit of combat, take them out into the world. And those who survive, we kit them up, gear them up, and slowly push back at these toxic ghouls and toxic gangs. And, you know, Evie, she's not, like I said this once upon a time, she's not evil. She's just necessary. And, you know, she takes care of her own. She takes care of people that are good. Good people. She's not evil. So, when we get her established, you know, you'll see the angel in Evie. The one, the thing that's had to not hide, but retreat. So that, let's call it, you know, the shield bearer, meaning what Evie is at the moment, what she's had to become, that psychology or that state of mind, let's say. It's, you know, it's protecting her, it's keeping her safe, it's helping her survive. And when she's safe, and when, you know, when she really is... Why are these suddenly so available? They used to be like... Didn't they used to be off limits? How long's that been there? And what was it I just picked up? That one, was it? Okay, I missed what it was. But anyway. We got that one again from the place where we started this episode with all the ghouls. Yeah, so when, you know, when she's in a position of feeling safe and actually she's secured her own environment, she's got a little bit of backup, people she trusts, she'll relax a lot. She'll become the angel that she can be. At least a lot more often. What was this place again? There are ghouls in here, is there? Can't really remember this place. But clearly we've been here before. Anyway, that's not what we're here for right now. Hello, hello, hello. Huh? Okay, we'll leave it. We'll leave it. All right, let's get our stuff out of here.
Shit. So let me know if you have any.
So I just brought it all because I couldn't really remember exactly what the ingredients were. Plastic, I think. Antiseptic. And then purified water, which I think we might have drank. Actually, now that I think about it. Oh no, we can make it. Sweet. I was glowing fungus, antiseptic, plastic, purified water. Epic! Yeah, we definitely want medic soon. Got 39 antiseptic, which is great. We've already got one of those antibiotics. Can we make any, can't make drinks here, can you? But we've got drinks at home. We're just a little bit thirsty. What do I have here? Let's get that right away into us. Oh, that makes us hungry, that's good. We've got food, do we? Got that one. And that one. So we're a little bit peckish. The rats are going down, aren't they? Slowly.
Don't know you, Scabba.
Can't get in there yet. We will. One day we will. I'd like to know what's in there. Something to, you know, the insurance issue. If we have to pickpocket the nurse, the doctor.
If you need a weapon, you've come to the right place.
What else you got? I'm not really after weapons.
Let me know what you'd like.
Although I will take a little look. I like that they've all got different quality as well. No. Ooh, 5mm rounds for that sort of sniper gun we've got. Might take a couple. just to give us a little bit of security. Take them, take them, just take them, don't need them. Rock and roll. Okay. Okay, I actually wanted to go in the bar. I went in the wrong place. Suppose we could sleep while we're here. Recover a little bit of health.
Yeah.
We've still got Nick's mission to do as well at some point.
Looking to buy?
Yes.
Here's what I've got.
Okay, what do you got? Radiation emitter. The whole place is already radioactive. Unless that does the opposite of what I think it does. Okay, where's the antiseptic? I'll take it anyway while we're here. Adhesive as well, that's a good one, isn't it? But that's very dear. Give me that. And you can take... That, why does that only have one value? £25 weight with 5 lead, that's pretty crazy when you think about it. Okay, just something cheap. What do I need? 9. What are you up to, monkey? What are you doing? Did you do a big fart, did you? No, I didn't hear it, but I felt the whole caravan shaking. Okay, I've got about 5 minutes left to write, then we're going to head out for a little bit. Yeah, we're going to have dinner. It's not quite dinner time yet. You've got an hour to wait. No, not now. You can wait for dinner now. All right, guys, give me a second. Let me get this done. Alright, trade complete. So we got a little bit of antiseptic there. Alright, so we got completed what we came here to do, which was create another Radaway. I suppose while we're here, it might even be worth, to be honest, making another one. So we don't have to come back so soon. So we need a couple of purified waters. We won't be able to, actually. Because I don't have the rest of the ingredients, the glowing fungus. What does Champa have?
What can I get you? Great.
Doesn't have any glowing fungus. She's got beer. We don't have any caps. It's fine. Alright, we'll leave it at that then. We're going to go and sleep on the doctor's bed. For... I don't know. What do you reckon?
Yeah?
Maybe we sleep till it's night time. Then we can risk... walking home at night for something a little bit challenging, a little bit mad, as Evie here loses her capacity for care, for caring about things that most people would care about. Thing about, where she's at, it's not that she doesn't care, it's just why I'm having a little bit of a hard time coming up with the right word for it. It's, when she's losing fear, she's losing the desire to, when you really care about something, you often think about it a lot, don't you? And you put a lot of attention and energy and effort into looking after and considering what it is you care about. Just think about any kind of relationship or a job that you've got a responsibility at, or if you've got kids or a pet or whatever. You've got to think about it, you've got to look after it, you've got to care for it. But Evie's becoming very impulsive. She sees things, she wants it. She doesn't really think outside of the moment, about outside of what's happening to her immediately. And what happened to my gun that I had? dropped them all, didn't I? I dropped them all in that place. So guess where we're going? Didn't pick them back up, or didn't die again after I did that run, I mustn't have done, because otherwise I would have them on me. They're not in here, are they? Oh, it's here. Never mind. Okay, fine, that's alright. I was gonna say, I would have likely picked them back up again unless I died.
Yeah?
Huh?
So yeah, she's becoming more impulsive, living the moment. And I don't even really know what else to say at this point. But
yeah.
Because she's losing fear, you know, because she's living so much in the moment, she's not thinking outside of what's going on. She has nothing to fear. And you know, if things present or put her in a position of danger, she'll act accordingly for her own survival. Outside of that, she doesn't really care what she's doing, and that's what I'm trying to get across here. So you're going to see her taking more and more risks, literally putting herself in more and more dangerous situations for higher and higher payoffs, bigger and bigger rewards. Now, we are ready to rock and roll. We're doing a little bit of food, which I don't have. Why don't I have food? Have I used it all? Or have I put it away without realizing? No, I actually don't have any. Alright, well, let's see what we can get from down here very quickly. So yeah, heading out more into the darkness. Facing these hordes of creatures more often.
You look like someone that needs a drink.
Killing more people. Taking out more survivors, groups of threatening survivors. I don't particularly want things with high rads. And now I remember why I couldn't buy anything. Okay, never mind. Alright, it's too complex for where we're at right now. We're in the momentum of moving.
Yes.
Getting out of here.
Yeah.
We don't really want to be here anymore, you know, that's the whole deal with moving out into the world. We just came here to build the Radaway. We don't really want to know these people. So, you know, when this series returns, you'll see Evie in full swing in terms of her potential, let's say. Yeah, let's get a save. It's pitch black, but we've got a night vision scope. So we'll be able to see quite well. Probably a lot better than any enemies too, actually, now that I think about it. Or at least better than any human enemies. Yeah, look at this. Awesome. So we're going to take Evie back. Oh no, we don't need to go there. We got all our gear. So her destiny is to go back to the survivalist bunker. She's going to have to continue to clear out these areas so she can level up. So she can get to the point where she can care for or establish a settlement. When she's ready for that, she's going to have to take on Bunker Hill and, let's just say, either eradicate everyone who's there. Possibly convince one or two of them to help her out. It depends on how they, I guess, on how they approach her. If they give her no option, then she'll have no option. So, that's going to be her first steps whenever she returns. Now, there's a small chance, very, very small chance, that I'll do a bonus episode a little bit later, which would be the last episode, definitely, of Evie until she returns. And otherwise, this has been the final episode of Evie's first part of her series. Now, like I said earlier or in the last episode, there will be a video releasing in about a week or so. basically asking people, the viewers, you guys, you know, what kind of getting a little bit of feedback for you from you on the channel format, the week sort of week-long format. Would you rather see a little bit more variation through the week, or do you like, you know, I'm sure different people have different opinions, but I just want to get a little bit of feedback on things, and also you know, when, how to kind of organize Fallout 4 with the Whispering Chills, Zombieland, Frost, and possibly another Ground Zero series as well. So anyway, look out for that in a week. You'll get to decide how quickly Evie returns, is basically what I'm trying to say. And I won't leave it too long anyway. She'll be back. But anyway, it's been fun. It's been a good week. It's been very, very, very difficult at times getting into this. I mean, look, in a whole week, 20 hours, 21 episodes, sorry. That's got to be close to 25 hours, given the maybe a little bit over an hour every so often. And this is all I've managed to kind of get into. Most of these places haven't been cleared. At least a lot of these haven't. Some of these haven't. That one hasn't. That hasn't. That hasn't. Don't think they have. Not sure. I can't actually remember. So yeah, it's been very, very tough getting to grips with this. But I do feel like now, especially with the help of the Conquest mod, it helps sort of speed things up a little bit. Now I'm getting to grips with the mechanics of Frost, and it is good. It's definitely difficult. You know, it takes a lot of patience, and for the way I play it, determination to keep trying to attack these places and to get through it, and dealing with the incessant explosive mine. The challenge of facing the mines. I really actually wanted to try to get to Diamond City and check that out at some point, but you know, Evie's got a long way to go. There's no rush with her. It's nice to be able to take our time with these stories and explore the world. So again, I'll leave it there. I hope you've enjoyed the series so far. I look forward to her return. Halloween, 31st of the 10th, 2082. So she should be back sometime next month. That's kind of my intuition on it. But yeah, we'll see how she goes. Thank you for joining me for this not quite final, but kind of final episode of Fallout 4 Frost. And I look forward to seeing you in the next one. Goodbye for now.